Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's video. But before that, let me inform you that the PDF of this session is downloadable. You can use our Telegram channel, the link of which is given in the description below, to download the PDF of this session. So now let's move on to the very first question of the day. So which country organized the International Election Visitors Program 2022? So here guys, India is the right answer. So Election Commission of India has organized this this program. Your task is to tell me that who is the Chief Election Commissioner of India at the moment, okay? Because that person is also chairing the Association of World Election Bodies, okay? AWEB. So this is also being chaired by the person who is the present Election Commissioner of India. So do tell me in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question. Which union minister addressed the Only One Earth, a discussion on environment, a special interactive session on environment at the Dubai Expo 2020? So guys, first of all, let me inform you that this Dubai Expo is basically an exhibition where the countries are allowed to have their pavilion. So India has also established its pavilion, through which India is trying to lure the investors so that they can invest in India back. At the same time, India is propagating its own ideals, okay? So on the line of that, only one interactive session was organized, okay? So by the Indian Pavilion at the Dubai Expo 2022, there the Minister of Textile, the Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, and the Minister of Commerce and Industry, all of these are the same person, okay? That is Piyush Goyal. So he addressed this session, and during this session, during his address, he made some points that need our attention as well, okay? Because they include some statements regarding the achievement of India in terms of renewable energy, at the same time the targets of India. So let's move into that, okay? I have already told you that this session, this interactive session was organized by India Pavilion. But at the same time, do remember that Bhamla Foundation helped the Indian Pavilion to organize this session. Now, what are the highlights from his speech, from Piyush Goyal's speech? First of all, guys, he gave us the new term climatepreneurship. Okay, like you have entrepreneurship. So similar term is coined by him, or he gave out this term. So basically, through this term, what he tried to say is he called for the startups who are already working in the climate field, or the activists who are working for climate resilience, okay, to take up this climate change seriously on a mission mode. Okay, so basically to give a boost to the climate activists and the climate startups. This term was coined by him, but this is not a scheme or any policy or any incentive. It is just the moral support that he has given through this term. Next point here is that India's installed non-fossil energy capacity, which is at present the fourth largest in the world. Now, all of these statements are given by Goyal himself. Okay, so at present, India's installed non-fossil energy capacity, that is renewable energy capacity, stands at the fourth position in the world. Okay, now it has increased by 300% in the last 7.5 years, basically from 2014 onwards, when the BJP came into power in India. From then onwards, according to Goyal, the non-fossil energy has increased, the installed capacity has increased by 300%, and at present it stands at 150 gigawatt in India, okay? And the target is to achieve 175 gigawatts in this year only, okay? Now guys, the next statement here is that India has one of the world's lowest solar tariffs. That is, the rate at which the solar generated electricity is sold in India is the lowest in the world, at which stands at rupees 2.14 kilowatt per hour, okay? Now the other statements. So India wants to become a leading hydrogen economy, because hydrogen, guys, is considered as the fuel of the future, okay? So in order to become the hydrogen economy of the world, the National Hydrogen Mission was announced in the budget. And under this mission, the basic primary goal of the government is to reduce the cost of hydrogen, generation of hydrogen energy to half. Okay, so from 350 kg, now the target is to reduce it to rupees 160 per kg by 2030. Guys, this is the target announced by Piyush Goyal. So this is important. Please remember this thing because this can be asked in your upcoming examination. So you have your RBI assistant probably in May. So this, guys, is important. Next is India's largest bio-CNG plant was also inaugurated in Madhya Pradesh. And this is, guys, the recent news. We have discussed this news as well. Tell me the exact location where this India's largest bio-CNG plant is located, which is also called as Godhan plant. Okay. Apart from this, under Swachh Bharat Mission 2.0 Urban, the government is working towards the processing of waste. Okay, so under this mission, 70% of the waste generated by India is processed. So this is, guys, achievement highlighted by him. And India's aspiration is to become free of single-use plastic by 2022. Now, guys, since 2014, India has seen an investment of $2.1 billion in the climate technology startups in India. Okay, so this is again an important and not that much of significance, but the other statements that are highlighting the target and the achievement of the government are important. Okay, so I hope that this is clear. Still, if you have any kind of doubt regarding anything, you can ask me. Next question is, where was the dialogue towards clean air organized by the Ministry of Environment and the Commission for Air Quality Management in the National Capital Region? Okay. So basically, this dialogue was organized by two stakeholders. One is the Ministry of Environment and the other one is the Commission for Air Quality Management and management in the National Capital Region. So where was this organized? It was organized in Gurugram, Haryana. Now guys, the person who is chairing this commission at present is M.M. Kutty. Next question is, who heads the task force to study the reasons for suicide in the Central Armed Police Forces? So guys, here the answer is VSK Komudi and he is the IPS officer. Okay. Now guys, recently in the Punjab's Amritsar camp of the Border Security Force, five people were killed. Okay. Five soldiers were killed and there was no alien element who had killed them. It was the people, it was the soldiers of BSF themselves who have killed each other because of some fight that broke out between all these soldiers. And the next day to this incident in West Bengal, also in Murshidabad, two soldiers of BSF were killed, and again the reason is cited as fratricide. So what is the probable reason for which the soldiers of these forces are fighting among themselves? So this is, guys, the task of this task force. This task force was set up by the Ministry of Home Affairs some months back only in order to study the reasons for which this fratricide is taking place. Okay, generally we use the term fratricide to indicate the killing by one brother, the killing of one brother by another brother. Okay, but in armed forces, the killing of the soldiers of the same unit is also called as the fratricide. Next question is, which state has launched the Kaushalya Matritva Yojana? So guys, under this scheme, basically, let me first tell you the scheme. So under this scheme, rupees 5,000 is given to the mothers for giving birth to a second girl child. Okay, so on the birth of a second girl child, okay, the financial assistance of rupees 5,000 is given to mothers. Now Chhattisgarh is the state that has launched this scheme on the occasion of International Women's Day. Which state has the highest camel population after Rajasthan? Okay, so usually we have this this illusion that camels only reside in Rajasthan. However, to some extent it is true. Majority of the population of camels is in Rajasthan, but apart from Rajasthan, there are other states as well. Majority of the states are the states sharing the land border with Rajasthan or adjoining Rajasthan. Okay, so here Gujarat is the right answer. So apart from Rajasthan and Gujarat, you have Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. All these three states also have a very limited, we can say, population of camels. Now, why is it in the news? Recently, Rajasthan government in its state budget has released this camel protection and development policy. And what is the need of such kind of a policy? First of all, know this fact that camel is the state animal of Rajasthan. And secondly, the population of camels has been decreasing significantly. So in order to stop this decrease in the population of camels, this policy has been launched, which basically envisages the protection, rearing and the increase in the population of camels in the state. Okay, so you would be amazed to know that according to the livestock census of 2019, the camel population across the country was 2.52 lakhs. Now, in 2012, this population was 4 lakhs. So this is a significant decrease in the population of camels across the nation. Okay, so the data is mentioned here. You can read it on your own as well when you will get the PDF. So now the present status quo is that 2 lakh camels are left in the state of Rajasthan. And guys, this is a precarious situation. The high alert is there. So that is why Rajasthan government has launched this policy. So I hope that all the facts are clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Which country has launched the Plastic Innovation Hub Indonesia project? Okay, so you have Indonesia in the question and in the options as well. But guys, this is not a mistake. It is put deliberately in the options. Okay, so now you have already guessed that Indonesia is not the answer. So the right answer is Australia. Okay, so Australia has launched this project in order to reduce the plastic waste and to tackle the plastic pollution that is there in the ocean surrounding Indonesia. Indonesia is an archipelago. I hope that you know this fact. Now tell me that how many islands constitute the nation of Indonesia? This is your task, guys. Mention it in the comment section below. Where has Microsoft established its one of the largest data centers in India? So here guys, Hyderabad is the right answer. So this is, guys, the fourth data center of Microsoft in India and one of the largest in India. Okay, apart from this, Mumbai, Pune and Chennai, in these three cities, Microsoft has already established its data center. Now this is another I would say a significant step on the part of Microsoft towards personalization of data. Okay, so localization of data, not personalization. Okay, so Indian government is trying really hard to localize the data, to have data centers in India itself where the data of India will be stored and not in some other country. So I would say this is a really good step towards Microsoft. Okay, but the other companies, other giants also need to work on it to establish the data centers in India itself. Next is, which company has launched the Lakshmi for Lakshmi, a women-led financial empowerment initiative? So guys, here HDFC Mutual Fund is the right answer. Now Lakshmi for Lakshmi, okay, so this initiative basically aims to connect the women investors or general women with the women financial expert. The purpose here is to make the women aware about the financial investment options that are there in the market so that they can themselves become financially aware and empowered. Okay, so that is the basic purpose, by giving them guidance and by connecting them with the women financial expert, they are going to boost their morale and confidence as well. Which of the following agency has released the Beware booklet? So guys, this has been released by RBI, and the purpose of this booklet is to aware the people, aware the general population about the about the mode of operation of the fraudsters, of the cyber fraudsters, and the measures that the people can take and the precautionary measures that the people can take while making a digital transaction. So all of this is written in this booklet. Okay, from exam perspective, I guess this much is enough for you to remember. Moving ahead, which bank has launched the House Work is Work initiative for offering opportunities to homemakers to rejoin the professional space? So guys, here Axis Bank is the right answer. So basically, through this initiative, the bank will try to provide the homemakers the opportunity to rejoin the workforce. Now, do not misunderstand it that Axis Bank is going to provide the job opportunities to women. No, Axis Bank job nahi dega, but Axis Bank will basically provide the guidance to the women, boost their morale, their confidence, and if it is needed, then this bank will also provide skill training to the women so that they can rejoin the workforce. Okay, job nahi dega bas. Okay, that is the thing. On how many models does the UPI 123 pay work? So guys, this is the new facility launched by RBI for the feature phones. Okay, so now the feature phone holders can also do the UPI transactions. Now the payment facility will work on four models. Okay, which are the four models? First is app based functionality. So application hoga in your feature phone and you can use that application to make the UPI payment. Okay, missed call. Okay, so there would be a number written on the merchant's outlet. Okay, like you have the QR code at the merchant's outlet, you go and scan your QR code with your smartphone. Here what you have to do is you have to dial that missed call and your payment will be deducted from your bank account. Next is IVR. So through the predefined IVR numbers, the UPI payment will be done if the feature phone holders dial these IVR numbers. And fourth option is proximity sound based payment system. So there are IT devices that use sounds in order to connect to the feature phones, to the offline devices. So in this manner, this technology will be used to deduct the payment from the bank accounts of the feature phone holders. So these are the four methods on which the 123 pay facility will work for the feature phones. And remember, RBI and NPCI both have launched this facility. Now we have the next question. Who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of the Shakti campaign of Lupin Limited? So guys, here the answer is Medicom, and remember, Lupin Limited is a pharmaceutical company. Where was the national workshop with state commissions for protection of child rights on contemporary issues pertaining to child rights organized by the Ministry of Women and Child Development during the Iconic Week? Okay, so here guys, Bhopal is the right answer. Now you would know that Iconic Week was celebrated by the Ministry of Women and Child Development from 1st to 8th March, okay, in order to observe the International Women's Day. So guys, this is the itinerary of all the 7 days that were pre-planned by the Ministry of Women and Child Development, and all of the initiatives we have already discussed, okay, in detail. On 1st March, the Bureau of Police Research and Development raised awareness on safety and security of women. This is not very significant. I don't think that this would be asked in the examination. Sri Manoraksha project launched on 2nd March. This we have discussed. Then on 3rd March, the theme of the 3rd March, okay, the theme of the third day of this iconic week was Women of Tomorrow. Okay, whereas the campaign that the government is running at the moment is Break the Bias. Okay, so panel discussions were held on Nari Shakti Varta Fireside Chat on Financial Literacy. So guys, this may be asked from you in the examination. Fourth and fifth day, on these two dates, a two-day national workshop with state commissions for protection of child rights on contemporary issues pertaining to child rights was organized in Bhopal. And on 7th March, Kanya Shiksha Pravesh Utsav was launched. We have also discussed this thing in PIB. Manish sir has discussed this Kanya Shiksha Pravesh Utsav in detail, and in Spotlight also this Utsav is provided to you. Okay, so this is nothing but the campaign in order to bring back the adolescent girls who have left their schools. Okay, so in order to bring them back into the formal education and skill ecosystem, this campaign was launched by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Okay, UNICEF is the partner in this campaign. 8th March, that is the International Women's Day. So Nari Shakti Puraskar, we discussed. This was given an International Women's Day conference for women police delegates was also organized. So guys, this was the itinerary of the International Women's Day, the iconic week. Okay. Moving ahead, where is the headquarter of International Paralympics Committee located? So it is located in Bonn, Germany. Now, why is it in the news? Because recently this committee has banned the athletes from Russia and Belarus to participate in Beijing Paralympics. Okay. So this is why it is in the news. Last question. Where is the ancient Stonehenge monument located? So guys, it is located at Wiltshire in England. Why is it in the news? Guys, this is basically an ancient monument that was used by the people in the historic times. Now, what is the purpose? The monument was used as a solar calendar. Okay, so right now it is again in the news because a British archaeologist has also said that this was used for determining the positions of sun across the year. Okay, so this used to serve the purpose of the solar calendar in the ancient times. That is the news for which it is in the it is here. The question is here. The max that the examiner would ask you is the location of this monument. That is in England, Wiltshire. So here guys, this video ends. If you like the content, then do subscribe the channel and hit the bell notification if you have any doubts. So provide your doubts in the comment section below. I will try to resolve them. Thank you so much for watching this video.